even is this? How could this possibly do anything? How does this work? If you've been asking those questions to how to work minecarts, this episode will help you. In this episode, I'm teaching you a lot of stuff about minecarts that will help you make roller coasters and really cool stuff. So to get on with the first thing is you have rails. Rails can loop around like this, as you can see. The only problem is, well, see, they don't move automatically. They move if you're on it, but that's it. Or if you're pushing it. But that's where activator rails come along. But as you can see here, they're just acting like a rail until you activate it. You can activate them in two different ways. Well, in any different power source. You can use redstone torches. Then you, as you can see, it's activated. And boom. And give it a shove. Wham. Or you can use, or for another popular one, you can use a block of redstone. The activator, have I been calling them activator rails? The powered rails help power it. As you can see here, normal rails can turn. The bad thing about powered rails is that, as you can see here, they can't turn. That's why you can't just always have powered rails. Okay, so you're starting, you're like, how do you make a stair? It's really simple. Just make a staircase like this with any block. And then before you're done, replace every top block with a block of redstone. Put down your powered rails going up. Then right here, put down some rails just like this. There, you got yourself a ladder going up. You should probably put down a rail here and minecart down, hop in. Boom. There you go. Those are called jumps. Also, if you need any more help with these, if this still doesn't make sense, I bet tons of other YouTubers would have like a whole entire episode just on how to use powered rails. Okay, so on to the next. There's detector rails and activator rails. Detector rails, here I'll show something with redstone. If you power a detector rail with anything, actually let's not do that. This is what they'll do if they get a sensing. They get a sensing of a minecart, they'll give a redstone signal. Also, sometimes if you're running through one of these, see how it turns on? It will kick you off. It will just hop you right off the minecart.
And the minecart will shake.
And that's my sister. Speaking of my sister, here's a note from my sister.
I came for your soul.
She's come for your soul, guys. Run. Remember to subscribe and we'll
leave a like.
That's clear.
And it?
These, no. These rails are powered also. And as you can see, it's doing this. This is this will automatically kick you off. No matter what you do, it will kick you off. A cool thing about this is it can be used as teleportation. So you can use these for elevators and stuff. It's kind of like the, what's it called? Detector rail. But this, no matter what, kicks you off. So it can be used as like a troll. If you're... If you're going down your little rail, and then out of nowhere, there's a block, and then an activator rail, and then the rails. It can be used as a troll like this. Flip on. Can be used as a troll like this. Kicked off. And right here, you can have like a pool of lava or something. I don't know if this will work, if you've never tried this. Ten likes, top 10 lava trick, top 10 minecart tricks, and auto saving. Well, you know a lot about it, but there's one more thing left. You know how to go up? You can go underground easily too. Just make it just like you're going mining and put your minecart down. And actually, now, whenever you're going down, surprisingly, you don't need any powered rails because it's powering it by the power, by the force, like how a normal roller coaster would work. And that's pretty much it for this episode. Stay tuned for next.